I mean, De Bruyne is up there as well in terms of he's class. Ronaldo's come and he's been good. But I'd probably put him comfortably at the top right now. If you talk about current form, I mean, at the minute, he's unstoppable. I mean, he's got 6 and 7 in the Premier League, 3 assists. And he just... One thing about Mo Salah as well, which is kind of underrated, is his movement in terms of the chances that he gets. Because obviously, you saw against Brentford as well, he can be a little bit lackluster. Went for a little dink, put it over the bar. But yeah, he's must be a nightmare to play against because he's relentless. He's small, but he's got that low sense of gravity. Yeah. He's powerful, yeah. Creates opportunities. Him and Mane seem to be on the same wavelength now. I know there was a little bit of uprest at times in terms of people talking about they were both maybe a little bit greedy, Salah maybe more than Mane, but at the minute they both look unstoppable. But Salah for me is at the top.
I don't disagree. He's absolutely outstanding. Outstanding. Even clearly and understandably, we're all talking about the goal, which was nothing short of remarkable. Actually, it's one of those wow moments. I told you, Benny, we were just sitting watching the game and he scores a goal and we were just looking at each other going, oh, what happened there? But even even the first goal, I've got to say, the first goal's brilliant.
When he runs, scoops it over and just goes, yeah.
He scoops it over, on he goes. Sadio Mane makes his run, blindside of Diaz. It's a great run. Diaz didn't see him coming. Diaz could maybe have opened up a little bit and saw him come, but it doesn't matter. Great ball in. The timing of the pass, yeah. The timing of the run, everything about it was absolutely fantastic. He's just very, very clever football player who... I think at this moment in time, Benny is right at the top of his game.
Yeah.
He's going to start demanding more, you can imagine. And if he did, then he's completely right to do that in terms of how important he is at the moment. His contract is up in 2023. And according to today's Guardian, he's on 200K. So De Bruyne is on 380. Grealish is on 300. And Virgil van Dijk is on 220. How much are Liverpool going to have to break the bank to keep him?
Yeah, they're going to have to go somewhere. And you were saying their verge as well, because when he's up for negotiation, he's going to want that kind of money as well.
Absolutely.
So, listen, I think he's well within his rights to be the highest paid if that's what he chooses. I mean, listen, he's vital to what Liverpool do. I guess the age is a stumbling block. But one thing, and I was listening to someone speak about it, is when you look at some of these top players in terms of them getting to 30, because it used to be you get to 30, then it's like one year,
yeah.
Maybe two, depending on what your relationship's like with the club, if you've been like there a long time. But when you look at the likes of people like Ronaldo, Lewandowski, Salah, who's come up to 30, Vardy, these guys are in immaculate condition.
What about Vardy? We were talking about him.
Yeah, I mean, he's 36 and he's still lightning quick. He's so sharp. So I think with Mo Salah, I think age might not come back. Might come back into it because he loves taking his top off. He gets booked every time he scores a great goal, takes his shirt off. He looks like he's in incredible shape. So these guys, I generally think, could be at this kind of level
for years.
36, 37, mm-hmm. Which means he's got a good, what, seven, yeah. 8 years left.
Did it give you guys any indication this game at the weekend who might win the league?
I did a wee bit for me in the respect. I think I said to you yesterday, the one thing that we all knew, I mean, absolutely knew for certain that we're going to win for some league. You looked at Lukaku going to Chelsea, Grealish City, Liverpool getting Van Dijk back, all these things, Manchester United, Ronaldo, Sancho, Varane, all that, threw it into the pot. But and I knew that the top teams, more than ever, would take points off each other. But the one thing that I said to you yesterday, would you, Benny, the one thing I really have been impressed with is Manchester City's level of performance against the top teams.
Yeah.
Be it Chelsea, be it Liverpool, be it PSG as well, to be honest. I thought they were all right. But I still believe there's a question mark out and out without an out and out goal scoring centre forward number 9.
That first half performance though from City where they peppered them, really should have scored a couple of goals at least.
They should have done, but I mean, listen, they've won the league before. We've seen them win the league before without a centre-forward. They did it last year. Mm. But the league's a lot stronger this year than it was last year. They managed to hold on to Bernardo Silva. I can't believe they even contemplated letting him go because he's a top, top player, by the way.
Yeah.
And when you look at the so-called big four, I mean, listen, you have to say that Manchester United probably look the least out of them four. I think Manchester City have looked good. I think Chelsea have looked good. And I think about Chelsea, they're top of the table and I'm still yet to see them catch fire properly.
Yeah, like
I agree. In certain games... they've won comfortably, but that game where they get it all together and you go, ooh. So they're still coming. Obviously, we've seen Liverpool. So, I mean, wow. This kind of game against the two gladiators, Manchester City versus Liverpool, there's an argument that either one of them could win the Premier League. It really is.
TalkSport Breakfast with Laura Woods. Monday to Wednesday morning, 6 till 10. On AM, on DAB, via the TalkSport app and on your smart speaker. TalkSport.